right-click the tab. Oh yeah, you can right-click the tab and dismiss it.
Yeah, but then I won't see all my claims when I do take more land, you know?
The new ones will pop up.
I don't know. When I did it last time, nothing ever popped up until I deleted it again. It just kept saying...
If you right-click it and click the check mark for dismiss for now...
Oh, okay. I was doing disable. Okay, there we go.
Do dismiss for now, and it goes away, and it'll come back if any other titles can be made.
Okay, there we go. That's all I wanted.
And Catholic Rebels, again.
There we go. Dismiss for now.
Okay,
it's cannot loot.
And your plot.
So where can I get princesses at?
The odds are slim. You could try to siege Constantinople. But
can wait for nine
that'll get you killed.
For claims? How do I do that? Oh no, get me out of here. It showed up. Bulgaria? $32 gold in there.
Nice.
I'm gonna try to raid, oh, that's not.
Somebody else trying to kill me? Oh,
risky.
Of course.
Travel up the river to Bavaria or Austria's.
Oh, we should go deal with that rebellion first before it grows. Yeah, the Catholic one.
Bavaria?
You're right.
Up river? Up here? This river?
Entertainingly enough, I might catch and kill this army on my way.
Or this one.
Not gonna go into hiding.
I don't know which river. There is no Bavaria. Well, that's certainly something, I guess.
Denmark just got their army killed. Or an army killed.
Realize the more ships you have, the more gold you can take. So I was shooting myself in the foot by taking less boats. Because I only had 1,000 men, I thought it was a waste.
You'd be better off. You'll make less money if you're taking like a lot of your own ships.
Whose ships can I? My levy ships then instead? Like my vassal ships? Oh, here they come.
Yeah, use your levy ships.
Oh, that would be, you mean my vassal ships?
Yeah.
Vassal levies?
Yeah.
They have 6. Amazing. So that's not gonna happen.
Yeah. Mine have 30.
Being raided right now.
Thanks for that advice, Kid Tony. I would have gone about that the wrong way, which would have been bad.
In and out nice and quick. How you doing, man?
So let's go straight for his capital. Invest in technology, military organization for sure.
I'm fighting people right now. It's not good. Are we winning or losing?
My vassals are declaring war on neighboring countries.
Gotta get out of here.
And he's going for Kent? That's just a mess I'll have to clean up.
Okay, well, that didn't work out too well.
Definitely need to set up some more commanders. Torsten.
Merchant, no princesses, but more gold. There's a lot of gold around here. Pope?
Alright.
Make it over there?
Oh, you want Torsten in the center. Torsten in the center. And...
Holy Father's ripe and rich for raiding, but also summon mercenaries. Yeah, but he's got 663 garrison, and most of his loot is already, half his loot is already taken. So...
Military organization is so important. Mostly it increases the number of retinue you can have, which retinue are obviously just the best troops you can have in the first place. So the more retinue you have, the better.
Oh no, another fight. Are you coming over here or what? They're enemies, but they're sieging that instead of attacking me. That's good.
You're welcome, no problem. It's something that I'm pretty sure a lot of people miss. Don't realize. So, this guy thinks he would be a better steward than Bjorn, but we'll give Bjorn a chance because he's only one less, and he might very well get it from a random event pertaining to that, or not random, from a event that can come from that.
Yeah, let's not try to do that. Let's just get out of here.
Never can make a huge retinue.
Gold.
That might explain it, in fact. I've had retinues in the tens of thousands. In fact, in the 20s of thousands. My Israel game, I had taken so much land, like right around here, that it was more like 40,000 retinue. Most of my wars, I didn't even raise other troops. And that was the last game I played before Rajas of India came out. Just to give you an idea of how long ago that was.
Venice? Venezia?
Venezia? Yeah, that's Venice. They are a fantastic, fantastic target.
Can I get princesses
from
them?
Possible loot, 84.4. No, you can't get princesses.
I'll take some of their loot in a minute.
Yeah, the merchant republics that still exist are fantastic targets. Amalfi probably has a ton too. There's his last 24.9. Genoa in Italy probably has. Oh no, it's already been looted.
I'm looting some islands, some crappy islands right now. Yeah, we're making big money now.
No, I played it some more after that. I haven't played it since Horse Lords came out, though. This is my first real couple of games back since Horse Lords came out. I don't have Horse Lords and I don't have Conclave because I feel that they're too expensive for what they offer. So I'm waiting until they go on at least 50% off sales. Actually, I love the Conclave DLC, but I would like for that to go down to at least $10 before I purchase it. Because I'm poor, honestly. But if I had more money, I'd be more willing to spend it, but I don't, so I'm not. What? Fairhair just declared war on Sigurd. I think Fairhair is another one of our
brothers. Well, not brothers anymore. I'm your nephew now.
After my uncle. No, he's a Yingling. Yinglings aren't related to us.
Yingling?
Yeah.
The heck is a Yingling?
Conclave is like buying a bag of wrenches, giving it to the game, and then getting them thrown at you by the game. But it is funnish. I think there are some ups and downs, but most of the bad stuff, like Shattered Retreats, is in the base game anyway. Is in the free patch anyway. So, like, the better parts of it, the extra management, which I love management because I'm a nerd, that stuff is, that stuff's worth it, but I don't think, I think that Paradox has gone crazy recently with the prices of their DLCs, compared to how much content is in them. You have the old ones like Art of War, which was a fantastic DLC that was $15. I'm not going to play that same amount for like Horse Lords. Sometimes you're okay with it, other times you hate it. Yeah, I think that's common. A lot of people really, really just can't stand it. And I kind of fall in the area where I could like it. They have improved, yeah. They have improved, you're right. The Shattered Retreats. The most realistic thing would be after a significant defeat where the morale of an army decreases to zero. The most realistic thing to happen would be for the entire army to holy crap, to completely disband. That would be the most realistic thing. And just kind of fade into the countryside again. Yeah, Shattered Retreat back when they just kind of ran off in a random direction for miles was awful. They tend to do a little better now. Though I still don't think it's as good as the Shattered Retreat mechanic in EU4.
Okay, looks like I'm not taking Venice's money today.
They have a big army standing there.
1,000, but that's more than I had, so I have 900. Well,
you take a 50% morale penalty for landing, too, so...
Oh, really?
Even if you had 3,000, you'd have gotten murdered.
That sucks. Would be good here, maybe not. Depends on if these guys come after me or not.
Take it like a man. Oh god, that 1,800 troops just decided not to come this way. That almost got interesting.
It's going well.
Your rating is going well for you?
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to come home with 280. I've only got 170 right now, but I can't see why I won't get much more.
None of my holdings. What if my holdings are
run
held by him?
Okay. think he was after me.
The army of the Duchy of Mide? Why does that matter to me? I'm really confused by that.
What? What about the Duchy of Mide?
The army of the Duchy of Mide. It has some of my seduction was horrible. Oh man, yeah, seduction when it first came out, I thought it was amazing. I thought it was just the best. because of how ridiculous it was.
What happened?
Well, remember in the first game we played when we were playing on that old patch?
Yep.
When everybody you tried to seduce, you got.
Yep.
And we wound up with like 8-10 lovers.
Yep.
Like, that was after it had been nerfed a couple of times. At this point, like, seduction focus is a lot worse than it used to be, which is good, because you can't just seduce everyone.
Yeah.
Like you could before.
You still do pretty good now.
Yeah. You do.
I had way too many kids. Larry McGarry. Quite the...
Hope he gets brave. He did. Diligent would have been good too, though.
Actually, I think I have to return home. I got wrecked.
Did you?
Yeah.
Bad defeat.
900 down to like 300 or something. They're coming after me? Better not be. I need more men before I can do that. And since that guy took, you know what? That zone. Gastric land, which is hilarious.
Alright. So now, what do I do with this brother of mine that I just put in prison? Do I... I'll ransom this bishop to himself. Do I ransom him to himself for that gold, or... maybe release him and increase my vassal's opinion of me? I'll do that. And now he likes me. Alright. So many dynasties were broken by seduction. Ruler is not really his father's son. Oh yeah, man. Happened a lot. Happened a lot. I'm gonna raise my vassal levies because for some reason, I don't know if it's just this focus. I mean, not this focus, just this religion, but I don't get any negative for just using their levies for everything. Have you noticed that? Have you tried it?
What?
Raising your vassal levies for, like, everything?
No, I haven't tried it. I always forget to push that button. I always forget to press raise vassal levies.
You should try it, because it's been working out really well for me. Like, I'm using them for raiding right now, rather than my own.
Oh. That Jarl that we hated, his son, is now going to start a war against me to degrade the... The war started already? Okay. He's my steward, too.
It's just that same duchy over and over.
I know. I gotta get all my people back with all my money.
Need to have like 40 ships.
I raised my vassal's levies. Stuff. It gave me 8 men.
Oh, right, yeah, because you're tribal. I forgot about that. I thought I was gonna start tribal, and I did not.
Yeah, what the heck, man? You put me in the Dark Ages while you're over here feudal as my brother.
I know. Like, that's why I assumed that I was gonna start tribal.
I was like, yeah, I want to start feudal this time. You're like, no, we'll start tribal as Vikings. No, you're still feudal, but you're a Viking too.
Which, I mean, is great for me, but less great for you.
Well, it's still great for you. and it doesn't really affect me, but I thought I was going to be able to follow in your footsteps and follow the kind of steps you're doing, but no, you're already at feudalism, so I don't know how to get there. My guy's almost back yet? Getting there. I have a lot of men that just...
38.8.
Load up.
So we're gonna... some of that's already been done. Holland's to 23. It's Mortain here. Sorry, that game doesn't need to be paused. These have 26. 23. This will do that. Gotta mute the stream real quick. Alright, Justice League Comic Con trailer dropped 3 hours ago. Nice, I'll check it out.
Comic Con?
Yeah. Apparently there's a Justice League movie that or something that was teased. No, they're not on fucking Looter. I'm a moron. And I died.
219 gold and 219 prestige. Alright, we're gonna drop my fleet. I'm gonna drop my armies. I'm gonna pull my armies up.
Continue to educate him myself? No, I suck. I'm a mastermind theologian, a legitimized bastard. No. I'm gonna send my son off to live with someone else. Search all. Both. Not in prison. Ooh. Married any. Ruler any. My religion. My culture. Adult yes. Great house any. I will give him to my nephew. I want you to educate my heir. Oh, not him. You. Don't turn him gay. Just make him awesome like you. Need a new chancellor, need a new steward, need a new seer. Have him proselytize in Lincoln. Oh, it's Catholic. Never mind. Oh yeah, it is Catholic. That's not what I want. Have him collect taxes in Jorvik. Him improve relations with who hates me. Everyone hates me.
Chief of Bastards doesn't like me.
Jarl of Man, Jarl of Gwynedd. Jarl of Mr. Drajar. Start with the Jarl of Northumberland. Jarl of Lancaster. We'll start with him. Improve relations. Alright. Don't want to piss off my vassals anymore right now. Alright. Time pass. Get the roads back to Gwynedd. Actually, we can go to Somerset. turn this army into raiders. Looters, whatever.
So when I do want to take this guy's duchy and his land, how am I going to do that? I'm going to revoke his duchy, but then how am I going to get the rest of the land?
Well, you can revoke it and get in trouble for it. You piss off your vassals if they don't.
But I can only revoke one thing at a time, right? Isn't that what I was told?
You can revoke them all while he's in jail. You'll just piss everybody off.
Oh. So I just randomly jail him and revoke all his titles?
Well, he'll go to jail when you,
When I revoke his duchy?
Putting down the revolt.
No, I'm talking about the guy that... the actual duchy that I want.
Oh.
Not this dude's.
Yeah, you can revoke and revoke and revoke all you want. You're just gonna incur tyranny.
So I can't get this land back?
Not unless he does something to give you a reason to take it from him. I mean, you could try to just assassinate his entire family line, in which case it would default to you when he died.
Just plot to kill him?
Yeah.
I'm gonna actually plot to kill him, his son first. Wouldn't that be wiser?
Maybe. I'm not really sure.
Because he's gonna die eventually.
Yes.
He's already 55. No one wants to join the plot. So it's just 43%. You think that's gonna work?
No, probably not.
Could I leave it up? Is there any chance of anyone finding out?
Only if it fires and it doesn't work out, because there are no people involved in it other than you.
I'll let it go then. For now, like, I'll let it keep going. See if it works.
Prince Ragnar has fallen under the sway of Cardinal Raymond and the religion he preaches. Cardinal Raymond goes to prison. And he'll be in the next great block. I need this war to be over. Petty King of Mead, Mind. I guess I can't hold a block. Have you held any blocks yet?
Blots? No, what's that do?
It's a decision. It's like an important decision that pops up every year for us. You basically sacrifice prisoners in your prison.
Okay.
And gain prestige and piety for doing it.
For killing prisoners.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Vassal levies raised too long. Okay, that can happen.
That sounds like it'll lead to people hating me, though. Because everyone who's ever in my prison is like vassals.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that might cause problems. Particularly if they're family, but...
I haven't gotten any prisoners from looting.
Have you not sieged down any, castles?
No, I've just been taking the gold off the top because it's easier. Well, the war's over. Voke title. Jarldom. Okay, who am I going to give it to now? Romanic pagan, right? That's all I'm looking for.
Yeah. That Uncle Sigurd is still alive and well. So apparently you can raise your vassals' levies for too long, but maybe only if they don't like you, because, like, Prince Ragnar is mad that I have his levies raised, but nobody else is.
Yeah?
Yeah. And that's my half-brother that hates me. I just dragged a bunch of people out of a siege.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah, acquired a bunch of young women.
Okay.
Prism in here. State intrigue? Nah. Three titles. Duchy of Bulglagson. You're gonna create.
Blessings upon your house, he says. I'm burning down all his territory, and he's like, blessings upon your house.
Minor titles.
Wait a minute. I am attacking in this war? I'm actually the... Wow. I didn't realize that I was the aggressor in a war at the moment.
Oh, you know what? That guy doesn't have the... I just realized. He doesn't have the duchy. So when I create it, I'm going to have the duchy. He only owns the land. Doesn't make it much better. But...
Yeah, it means you still have to revoke two things from him.
Right, but I don't have to revoke the duchy. I can have a great plot. What does it give you?
The great plot? A bunch of stuff. It gives you...
I have no prisoners,
money.
Though.
No.
What does it give you, though?
It doesn't do. You might get some money from your vassals, and it also has a chance of giving prestige. It gives prestige when you sacrifice somebody and piety when you sacrifice somebody.
So just prestige and piety. It just doesn't seem worth it.
Well, I mean,
mission a runestone.
That also is a prestige thing.
And you've done once in a lifetime. Alright, I'm gonna do that. Did it happen? Decided to commission and raise a grand runestone. Speak of me? Speak of my father? Speak of my mother? Who should I make it? I think I should make it for me.
There you go.
Or should I make it for my father? They could speak of me.
I'm
making a runestone to myself, and yet my guy said he wanted to be humble about it. It's like, what? He said there's not much to say about me, so why am I making the runestone? Anyway, what were you saying?
It's not much to say about me.
Yeah, that's what the thing was. What do you wanted to say? Oh, there's not much to say about me. Like, what?
Nice. 395 gold from that rating.
Okay, we're gonna go for tribal organization medium.
Hey, I just gained the trait Viking.
Stone is raised. Mastermind theologian. 100 prestige, 100 piety, monthly piety, diplomacy, general opinion, plus 10. Boom.
Just like sacrificing vassal troops to get this war over quickly.
Still can't revoke his title. I got medium tribal organization, I can't revoke his title still. Why not?
I'm gonna keep this tribal holding. But I'm already over 50, so I should probably. Well, my focus is hunting. Good. Looks like my son is gonna turn out alright.
Alright, I'm gonna try to gain all this land back.
How many sons do I have? Fucking four. I have four sons. What am I gonna lose? County of Tyrone. County of Teviotdale, County of Dunbar, County of Lothian, and the Jarl of Lothian. So I'm going to give my youngest son Tyrone right now.
How do I take this title from him?
Ken Dolfer is supposed to get Dunbar and Teviotdale. Second son, my third youngest son, Prince Hawker. It's the county in the Jarldom of Lothian.
Oops.
So you can get rid of one weak claim, get rid of vassal levies, Alfonso of Difflin, get rid of that warning, and press to show the claims. Open council position, I need a new seer. Alright, start the game with bosses.
Okay.
Build a new castle. Cost 752. Dangerous factions. Two of my nephews want to lower crown authority. So I'll send some gifts. Make sure they have honorary titles.
Swedish revolt.
To be my designated region. How does that make you feel? Hold a great want, absolutely. I can hardly wait. Now for the human sacrifice. Where's your blessed virgin now? 50 prestige and 25 piety. 2, 3, 4. Oh, and it also raises your vassal's opinion of you. The block.
Blot? Okay. What if the vassals are in the blot?
Yeah, those ones might not be thrilled about the situation.
Well, it's about to happen. I'm seizing gastric land back from the evil people who stole it from me. Okay. So many vassals will die in the process. That's just how it is, right?
Yeah, I understand.
My guy's so old, like, I don't care if everybody hates me. I'm getting that land back for my child. What am I losing?
Game keeps telling me about, Oh, I've forgotten what I was gonna say.
Oh.
That's pretty impressive.
Yeah. I may need a relief effort sent over here.
Yeah, you losing?
I'm gonna be soon if these two connect together.
We actually aren't allies.
We'll fix that. Dangerous factions. Uh-oh. We're about to have a second uprising coming up.
Send people out to find it.
I'm also gonna take Ostergotland and just... because... even with medium tribal organization, I can't revoke people's titles. So... I'm stealing them by force.
Oh shit, no, I gotta bring this fleet back home first. I keep doing that. Castle town. Saddle my horse. Dogger looter, now get on.
His son is now voted as the heir? Wow.
Oh, are you elective Gavelkind?
Agnatic elective Gavelkind. Whatever that
I'm
means.
Agnatic cognatic Gavelkind, not elective. Looting. Oh shit. My brothers are energetically finishing the conquest of England. Stressed or off? Neither.
My hunting dog died.
Aww. I think the worst part of that is you lose the health.
I know, now my guy's gonna die, I think. He's 63. I think that hunting dog is all that was keeping him alive.
My dude lived to 75 with the great pox.
I need help over here.
Do you?
Yeah. Well, right. I wonder if anyone will heed my call. I doubt it, but let's see.
I think they have to if they don't want to rebel.
No one joined me. I think most of them rebelled, honestly.
Alright, give me a moment. I can bring somewhere in the region of 4,000 troops.
Probably only need like 1,000.
Alright, I'll just bring the fleet that I've, or the army that I've got together already then.
Okay. I have 1,000, they have 1,200. Sometimes they split up. I haven't caught them split up long enough yet.
Yeah, I've just got to drop off the little bit of loot I just got and then I'll come over. Oh wait, we're not allies.
Oh no.
I can offer to join your war though.
There we go. Dear cousin, it said. Wait, we're only cousins now?
Yeah. That's why I can't,
Wow.
That's why I can't ally with you.
Do they need a marriage tie?
Yeah.
I can't. My wife won't let me marriage, like, arrange marriages. So, there's
Wait,
that.
Wait, is your wife your,
My what?
What do you mean your wife won't let you arrange marriages?
None of my kids I can arrange marriages on, so you tell me why that is.
Oh, because they live in your wife's court.
Yeah.
Right.
Navajari? What? I don't want to inherit that. It's in the middle of nowhere.
I see them. You just keep on with the sieges. I'll go take care of their army.
Alright. I'm ill. Oh no. I need to take this war before I die so I can inherit Gastergland. That's why I did all this.
Tell us more about this mythical realm of Hindustan.
I think you arrived.
I'm just gonna chase their army around. I'll beat him in a couple of battles, and then I'll leave.
Alright, we got it.
Oh, it's over. Look at that. Wow.
I'm gonna execute him as well.
My gay nephew has 27 martial. He may be
I'm
gay.
I'm the heir. Okay, all I have to do is kill this kid. And I'm become the heir to Gastergland. I killed everyone else.
Nice.
Or I sent them all into hiding because I tried to arrest them. Oh, I can revoke the title. Oh no, please tell me you're still here.
I left.
He just rebelled. Please, I need this. I need this.
Is that all one guy?
This is heirs. Is it one guy?
Yeah.
Wait, he owns all of this? That is not good. Why does this little kid own so much?
Oh no. Where's his army forming up? Can you see it?
Yeah, from the south. I'm actually gonna take him out before he gets here.
Alright, I'm coming ashore at just.
Oh, my illness went away. You gotta hurry up though. I gotta take Gastrogland before the end.
Accept that offer.
I accepted it. I also started another war. You can help me take Ostergotland quickly. May as well, right? Because I want these lands before I die, and then I want my son not to be tyrannical like I am.
Is your second son landed? Because if he's not, he's gonna wind up with that land that you want.
Okay, let me land him. What do I give him? I'm gonna give him that crappy island that I don't even really care about right now. My second son. I can't land him right now, why not?
Because he's not in your court.
Ugh. Then he is going to inherit some crap that I don't want him to. Alright, I'm going to fight for Gastrogland up here. You go take those things down there, I guess. I want my land. Then I'll be happy. And all my vassals can be happy with all the new land I conquer they can have. Just give me Gastrogland, Upland, Sunderland, Ostergotland.
Son just came of age.
Son came of age?
Yeah, my first son.
Oh. Look at that.
He's ugly. But he's got decent martial skill, okay stewardship. He'll do.
Okay, there's another rebellion coming. Just saying.
Well, thankfully, my kingdom is mostly stable right now.
Yeah, thankfully. What do we have arrested? No one. I've put our country into chaos just so I can have my land back, but I need it. I need it. You're right though, if I would have thought of that, I would have given my second son land so he wouldn't have inherited Gastrogland and then given it off to like a million other people. So ridiculous.
Yep.
Let me call my vassals and see if anyone will join in. They joined. Look at that. We got people to join. What?
I said, which war? Both of them?
I have no idea. But at least people are around. You doing okay down there? Oh, we won one war.
Can you handle the other one?
It's two other ones. I don't think so.
Alright, well, I've got a Catholic revolt I have to go back and take care of. Alright. I'll come back.
Alright. Who's this kid? King Ericr has inherited the Jarldom of Smolin. Yes! What did I inherit?
A duchy. Keep it. When you die, one of your kids will take it. So maybe it'll prevent your primary, the stuff that you want to keep, from being taken.
Oh, the Jarldom of Smolin I inherited. Okay. That's fine. I'm wounded too. Oh, I have gastric gland now? Yes, that's what I wanted. I also got Jamaltaland. Raise an even bigger army now. What's going on over here? Why am I getting wrecked? Where's my army? 154. I'm losing badly now. What happened?
I don't know. I'll be back very shortly. I need to take care of this uprising.
Okay, I got another rebellion now.
Oh god. Alright.
What's going on up here? Please. Send help. We're not okay.
Coming. About 4,000 troops with me.
Things weren't going so hot for me. I can't have my guy die before I win these wars, though, either.
I've got to... offer to join your wars. I don't know if it's gonna let me in. Hey, you caught another execute! That's wonderful, Lammy. I don't know how long ago you said that.
Got an execute today,
4 minutes ago. And,
very interesting.
Tony also said that he was gonna go play some games himself. And I missed it.
Wow, there's a lot of...
What, will you accept these? I ask to join your war.
Why didn't I get them? There, now I got him.
There, I have an A-War of yours. Apparently I have to offer one at a time. I'll siege back your capital for you.
Thank you. Which one am I losing? Swedish Revolt.
I'm not in that war.
That's the one I need, because I'm negative 46%.